To get started, navigate to the Trade tab and select the Crypto Trading Mode. First, let's set up our view settings. The Crypto Trading Mode can display up to 4 charts, depending on how much space you have inside the Trade tab area. If you have the right sidebar open, you can view more charts by hiding it. Also, this is where you can set your default increment for quantity and price when using the arrows during order entry, which we'll go over shortly. You will also know which account you're trading crypto in by referring to the current crypto net lick displayed at the top. When you start accumulating crypto positions, you will see the number listed reflect your total crypto position's total value. To clean things up, we'll display the right-hand sidebar and view 2 crypto charts. Now, let's set up a crypto order. First, let's choose which coin we want to trade by selecting it from the drop-down menu in the corner of each chart window. Within each chart, you can zoom, choose a display or hide the data box, the chart type, and adjust your chart view settings. Also, the order ticket will list at the bottom. Next, let's set up an order. When trading crypto, you'll have 3 different order types: market, limit, and dollar market. What makes crypto unique is that you can route trades for a partial or decimalized quantity. Based on that, you'll only be able to adjust specific criteria based on the order type you choose. With a market order, you can only adjust the quantity. The order will fill immediately after sending. The order will base on the quantity entered in relation to the current market price, which is the ask when buying or the bid when selling. A limit order, you can adjust the quantity and price. One thing to keep in mind about routing a crypto limit order is that the limit price you enter is in relation to a full coin's value. So, if you're trying to buy half a coin, you still must base your limit price on the full coin's value. The estimated dollar amount that appears above the quantity field will take into effect the quantity entered. Then, there's dollar market. With a dollar market, you can only adjust the dollar amount. Basically, a dollar market order will route a market order based on how much you want to buy or sell. One thing to keep in mind is that you'll only be able to establish net long crypto positions. As a result of this, if you try to set up a short position, you will see the following message. Another thing to keep in mind is that cryptocurrencies trade 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. So, all orders are effectively good till cancel orders, or GTC orders, since a day session does not exist. This primarily affects limit orders that are working, and they will continue working until they are canceled. We'll demonstrate each order type and how they work. Now, we'll click on the Buy tab to set up an order to buy. Now, let's set up a market order on Bitcoin, BTC. Since we already have it selected in the drop-down menu on the top left corner, we'll now select Market. You'll notice below that the only field that you have control over is the quantity field. Now let's enter our quantity. You can either use the arrows or enter an amount manually. When you're ready to send the order, click Review. Review the order details, including the account the order will route through and the estimated total transaction cost. If you need to make a revision, click Cancel. Or if you're ready to route the order, then click Send Order. The order will fill right away. You can view your position above the order ticket and in the Positions tab. Now, let's set up a limit order on Bitcoin Cash instead. We'll return back to the Trade tab and select Bitcoin Cash. Since we're setting up a limit order, we'll select Limit from the Order Type menu. You'll notice, with Limit selected, we only have control over the quantity and limit price. In this case here, if we only want to buy half a coin, we can enter 0.5 and base our limit price on a full coin's value. The estimated dollar amount listed above the quantity will list the estimated dollar amount based on the quantity you entered in relation to the limit price you specify. Keep in mind, when using limit orders, it may not fill right away if the price you entered is away from the market. Once satisfied, click Review. Again, review the order ticket and click Send when we're ready to route the order. Since the limit price entered was away from the market, it will continue working until the ask price comes down to our limit price. We'll go over how to edit a working order shortly. Now, let's set up a dollar market order on Ethereum. First, we'll select Ethereum from the drop-down menu, then select dollar market from the order type menu. With a dollar market order, we can specify how much of a coin we wish to purchase, which in this case will be $100, as already listed. The estimated quantity will display below and route the order based on the dollar amount you wish to buy. You will only know your actual quantity until the order fills. Once we enter the amount we wish to purchase, we can click Review. Again, review the order and click Send when ready. The order should fill right away, and this is where you can see your actual quantity filled. Now, let's go over how to replace and cancel a working crypto order. When it comes to replacing or canceling a working crypto order, generally, the only order type that will appear as working are limit orders, since market and dollar market orders fill immediately after sending. That said, let's locate our working order inside the Overview tab in the right-hand sidebar. Remember, the price you enter is based on a full coin's value. To replace a working order, right-click on the working order and select Replace Order. You'll return to the crypto trade mode. The chart and order ticket will outline in yellow, letting you know where you can edit your working order. In this case here, we'll adjust our price closer to the market and then click Review Edit. Check our order details, then click Send. The old order will cancel and the new order will start working. Lastly, if you wish to cancel a working order altogether, all you need to do is locate the working order, which we'll do again by going to the Positions tab. Again, locate the working order, right-click on the working order, and click Cancel Order. Now, let's go over how to close or manage a crypto position. Lining up a closing order is just like any other order. Again, locate the position, right-click, and select Close Position. Just like replacing an order, the chart and order ticket will outline in yellow, letting you know where you can enter your closing order. You will also notice, since we are selling a long position, the sell tab will be outlined in red. There, you can select your order type. When selecting market, you can enter the quantity you wish to close at the current market price. You can refer to your total quantity by referring to the position detail located above the order ticket and adjust the quantity accordingly. When selecting limit, you can enter a specific amount of your current position you'd like to close in relation to the limit price of a full coin. Then, with dollar market, you can set a dollar amount you wish to sell. Again, the net lick listed in the position details above the order ticket will show you how much you have available to sell. In this case, I want to close my entire Litecoin position at the current market, so I'll enter a market order. So, I'll select market order to sell my entire position. When ready, I'll click review, and then send, and the order should fill right away.